Hello everyone, ending credits here. And blimey, what an amazing last few weeks we've had in the world of shulker farming. If you didn't see it, 2 weeks ago I did a video on how scaffolding could be used to move shulkers around, and how this could be used to create a simple, but effective, one-dimensional shulker farm. Thanks for all the amazing comments and feedback I got in that video. I really appreciate your support. However, a lot more has been going on in the world of shulker farming. First of all, recently, Ianxofour did a great video on a very simple portal-based design. While portal-based designs are fairly common these days, Ian shows off a lot of cool new mechanics and gives a thorough guide on how to move shulkers around in survival. If you haven't watched his video, I highly recommend it. And do check out the rest of his channel, where he does a lot of amazing work making easy-to-build farms for survival. However, what I want to talk about today was a video from Etho's lab, where he built an amazing new shulker farm design on a Hermitcraft server. Since then, a number of people, including myself, have been tinkering with this concept, and I think it's fair to say that this represents a revolution in shulker farming. So what made Etho's concept so special? In a conventional shulker farm design, we put a lot of resources into a single breeding cell. Etho takes the opposite approach, where instead of having just a single resource-intensive breeding cell, Etho effectively has many, many simple breeding cells, which in this case are just given by the walls of this chamber. The layout of this farm means that shulkers will be forced to fire up and down until eventually they hit themselves. Instead of relying on manually replacing the shulker in the breeding cell, Etho's design basically uses the fact that the shulkers will effectively fill up the breeding cells by themselves as they teleport around. There's no need to keep the breeding shulker alive. The duplicated shulkers don't have to be removed from the teleport radius. The shulkers can be kept within the farm indefinitely, relying on the fact that they'll eventually kill themselves by hitting themselves. This is such a cool concept, and a completely different approach to the conventional shulker farm design. What Etho has built is the very first shulker reactor. However, there are two problems with this approach which need to be solved. First of this is you need some way to aggro the shulkers so that they'll shoot bullets and open their shells. Second, you need to be able to collect the drops from the shulkers from within the cells. To collect the drops, Etho relies on having an open cell design where the shulker cells will simply drop to the bottom of the farm where they can be collected. To aggro the shulkers, Etho uses the water column to push the player past the shulkers. This is a bit annoying, as it requires the player to AFK at a particular location. To get around this, I had a go at trying a similar design, but using snow golems to aggro the shulkers. However, protecting the golems and ensuring that all shulkers were in range of a golem made this design difficult to pull off. Instead of trying to make a large number of efficient killing chambers where shulkers inside could be aggroed by snow golems, instead, I realised I could use scaffolding to force shulkers into a smaller number of killing chambers, which meant I could use just a handful of golems at the centre. This design uses a recent trick from Ianxofour's video, where golems can fire up through scaffolding, but shulker bullets can't pass back down. The drops are collected through water streams and pushed into the middle of the farm, where they can be collected at a central point. This farm design is completely redstoneless, and produces just under 200 shells per hour. However, this design from Reddit user HF147 produces over 500 shells per hour. Instead of using golems to aggro shulkers individually in each cell, it uses a central shulker next to a golem to aggro all the shulkers in a given radius via social aggro. It just goes to show that this reactor design concept has a lot of potential. And remember, this is just the start. However, there are a couple of questions that would be good to answer. Firstly, how do we build the most efficient reactor design? And secondly, are reactors any better than conventional single cell farms? Let's do some maths. A shulker can hit itself 8 times before it dies. On average, the shulker will attempt to duplicate 6 out of those 8 times. If you remember from my earlier video, I talked about the space efficiency and teleportation success rate. For each of those 6 attempts, the shulker will duplicate if it successfully teleports. The average number of shulkers generated by a given shulker is 6 times the teleportation success rate. This is an important number, which we'll call the initial duplication rate. However, to prevent shulkers from multiplying indefinitely, Mojang added a mechanic where the chance of duplicating decreases as more shulkers there are. For a reactor, this means that the rate of shulkers duplicating will gradually decrease as more shulkers are added, until it reaches an equilibrium point. Specifically, each shulker in a 17 by 17 by 17 region around the shulker reduces its chance of duplicating by 20%. If we say that D is the average number of shulkers around each shulker, then the average number of duplications over a shulker's lifetime is given by 1 minus 0.2 times D times by the initial duplication rate, which is 6 times the teleportation success rate. The reactor will reach equilibrium when, on average, each shulker duplicates exactly once over its lifetime. This gives us the formula 1 minus 0.2 times D times the initial duplication rate equals 1. We can rearrange this in terms of D to get that D equals 5 times 1 minus 1 over the initial duplication rate. Since each shulker dies in 8 hits, the rate of shulkers dying within the reactor is 1/8 of the rate of which each shulker hits itself times by the number of shulkers within the reactor. We can estimate the number of shulkers within the reactor by multiplying the number of 17 by 17 by 17 regions by D plus 1. Since we can work out D, we can hence work out the formula for the rates of the farm in terms of the space efficiency, the per shulker hit rate, and the number of regions. If we plot the rates against space efficiency, we see that the rates initially increase rapidly, but then plateau at a space efficiency about 20 to 30%. This is a combination of diminishing returns on teleportation success rate, based on the space efficiency, and also we're approaching the hard limit on the number of shulkers we can have around each shulker, which is 5. For a single cell farm, if we ignore the time penalty of replacing shulkers, the number of shulkers generated is approximately equal to the teleportation success rate times the per shulker hit rate. Assuming the shulker hit rate is the same for the cell-based farm and reactor, we can plot the relative rates of a single cell farm versus a single region reactor. As you can see, for lower space efficiencies, both farm designs are fairly similar. However, for high space efficiencies, single cell farms get much better rates, almost twice as high as an equivalent reactor design. So are reactors just a worse version of single cell farms? Well, reactors have a few big advantages over single cell farms. First of all, we don't have to be able to quickly remove shulkers from the reactor. Second of all, we don't have to replace any shulkers. And finally, even though we're talking about a single region reactor here, a single agro chamber in a reactor can support multiple regions within the farm. With that in mind, and the relative ease of building reactors versus single cell farms, I think we'll see a lot more reactor designs coming in future. Just one more thing I wanted to talk about before the end of the video, which is, what if, instead of grinding all the shulkers within the reactor, we pull out a portion of the shulkers and grind them externally? So, does this work? On the one hand, we have fewer shulkers within the reactor to duplicate, but on the other hand, we're also increasing the individual duplication rate. I did the maths on this, and as you can see from this graph, we picked the optimal rate of shulkers from the reactor. We can approach the rates of a single cell farm with a reactor setup. I also ran the numbers on what happens if, instead of collecting all the drops within the reactor, we only collect the drops from the shulkers removed from the reactor. This might be useful, as it means we don't have to worry about designing our reactor cells to allow for easy drop collection. It turns out that not only can you get similar rates to a basic reactor setup, but you can even exceed it. I'll include a link in the description to the calculations for anyone who is interested. However, just bear in mind that this is just theory, and there are a couple of barriers to putting this into practice. One issue is that to maximize the rates in this way, we need a high space efficiency within the reactor, but we also need to remove a large proportion of the shulkers generated from it, and it's not clear how you could achieve this in practice. Secondly, to maximize these rates, We also want to keep the number of shulkers within the reactor fairly low, but this can make it harder to sustain reaction. Nevertheless, I think this could still be quite a promising avenue to explore, and I'm looking forward to seeing what sort of designs people come up with. There's a lot more to talk about shulker reactors, but hopefully this video has covered the main points. Thank you very much for watching, and until next video. Bye-bye.